know, I'm proud of what I've done. It's got me where I am, but it's not where I want to remain. I got more I want to go. The voice, internal voice I've always listened to, has gotten me to here. It will continue to get me if I listen to it. You know, when they say stay grounded, that's what that is, staying grounded. Not listening to the success. Not listening to all the people that are on your payroll telling you everything you want to hear. Listening to what's inside. Same guy inside that you when you had nothing, not even a pot to piss in. Same guy there as I am now, which I will be the same one there, staying grounded. Because that guy got me to this level. And I stay grounded, he'll get me to this level. And I'll keep getting going. And as I go, it's not about overcoming things and success and everything else. It's about the pursuit. Finding fear chasing, going after these things. If it doesn't work out, no big deal. We can redo it again. It's not in life, you don't have one shot at it. And here's a real fucking thing. When you fail, and what you thought was so right, this is what I wanted to do, and this happened over and over with me. I went with everything I had, I came up short. I didn't sit back like you did, Joe. Go to the mirror and see failure. I saw motivation. I evaluated my failure. Yes, I did not succeed, but I didn't see it as failure. I saw it as learning, a life lesson. What can I pull from this? More often than not, I found out that my direction, the voice inside, was a little bit off of what I really wanted. You know, I was in that same direction. I was shooting towards the ballpark. I wasn't hitting it. It wasn't a bullseye. And it was slightly off. Once I listened to it, listened to this, not everybody else. Reapplied my efforts, success. That's when it gets special, man. You know, I always say this, the marathon runner, right? The guy that wanted to never run before, wants to run a marathon. He tells everybody, I'm going to do this. I'm like, you're crazy. You can't do it. He just keeps on going. He keeps on believing in it, you know? That big journey, man. And it seems monumental, but every day he starts knocking off a piece. And slowly and surely, that 26.2 miles after running zero at once, and then a couple miles, and then maybe 10, and maybe all of a sudden, it seems reachable. When a month or two ago, it didn't seem reachable. Now his buddies are out partying and everything else, having a good time. And I'm sure, you know, he would love to do that, but he's sacrificing today for the investment tomorrow. Training, running. Now all of a sudden, what was impossible is within reach. 26.2 miles, I could do that. And he does do it. And he crosses that finish line, physically exhausted, mentally sharp. Picture taken, the old man. He looks back on that for inspiration for the next endeavor, remembering those 4 months of training, forever, always remembering, pulling from him. Where his counterparts out partying, drinking, couldn't even tell you one joke that happened in those 4 months going out partying. Couldn't tell you anything that happened. They're living in the moment. That moment doesn't ensue a memory of the future to look back on. It's dead. It's wasted effort. Marathon runner, he goes there. He's got something to remember upon. He's building something. He's found confidence in himself. He's next step, next step, next step. The reason why most people fail, guys. They fail because their insight of how they see things. They focus on the journey ahead. And that's all they focus. On how long it is. Never looking back and seeing how far they've already come. It's a big thing there.